about your work.
Yeah, in this work, I first fabricate, how to extract my chitin from crab shells. We need to deprotein process and demineral process. And these two processes was repeated for three cycles and to remove this protein and the mineral inside. And after that, I just do treat my chitin with partial distillation with sodium hydroxide solutions. Yeah. After that, this partially distillated chitin was prepared. And after that, I treat my chitin with microfluidization, so nanochitin can be prepared. So after that, I just want to prepare nanochitin hydrogel and aerogel. But at first, I want to just mix my nanochitin and cross-linker. Just mix and wait for a week. It's just a solution still. So after that, I found maybe frozen is a good technique for the preparation of these nanochitin hydrogels. So I first mixed my nanochitin and cross-linker to aldehyde and frozen at -20 degrees. And after that, just freeze drying or thawing, I can prepare nanochitin hydrogel and aerogel successfully. Yeah.
What is the best unique property?
Unique property? Yeah, for this research, I believe this prepared nanochitin hydrogel was, and the aerogel was flexible. I think.
You can see this flexibility.
Yeah, flexible. And it has pH-dependent shape recovery property. Yeah. For this, you can see, for this nanochitin hydrogel, after compression, for nanochitin hydrogel, after compression, it can achieve the shape recovery at the pH, at the acid solution, but not in alkaline solutions. And for this, aerogel, it can bear almost complete compression and recovery.
And recovery.
Yeah, yes. Yeah,
excellent.
I see this is a unique property.
Great, thank you so much for telling us about your work.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.